6:15 in the morning, and night still lingers at Crook Street as the first passenger of the day, the motor train to Kenyon Junction, eases out of the platform. At first light, the first Deansgate trip of the day sets off down the bank. Quarter of an hour later, at 6:50, the first Manchester Exchange local is off as well. Just as the 4-foot shunter returns with the Deansgate trip. At 6:57, the ex-Holton Junction mineral engine arrives back at Crook Street light engine. It has spent most of the night working coal wagons from the three collieries accessed from the short LNWR Holton Junction branch, which in turn links into the colliery's own railways. as the coal engine is retiring to the shed, the next Deansgate trip bustles down the bank. It's a very busy time at Crook Street, and the next arrival is already approaching at 7:05, the Wigan Central Local. Meanwhile, at Deansgate, the shunter is preparing the return trip to Crook Street. Back at Crook Street, the Sanderson Siding Minerals are just arriving. There's an 8-minute window to get the runaround done, so the crews waste no time. And bang on time, the 7:28 Manchester Exchange local rattles over the point work into the station. At the same time, the Deansgate trip arrives into the yard, so it doesn't interfere with the busy workings of the main line. The shunter, however, takes this next small window to come onto the back of the Sanderson's minerals in preparation to working them into the yard. Not before the 735 Wigan gets dispatched. Thank you. The next arrival is another light engine, a D-Class 080, arriving at the same time as the third Deansgate trip rattles off down the bank. This light engine working is to provide motive power for the Springs Branch goods later on, and on Mondays only, it works in a mineral train from Patricroft. At 10 past 8, the next Manchester local gets underway. and with half an hour till the next Manchester local, the crew of this coal tank have time to oil round and rake out the fire, and maybe get a well-earned cup of tea.